Hello everyone, welcome back. This is the video dedicated to the writing sample for the fine writing fountain pens, the Bronze Age model and the Golden Armour model. Some details that I forgot to mention in my main review video regarding the diameter of the section of the pen. We have from here to here 9 to 11 millimeters. So that's a good size for the section. Also, regarding the fountain pen nibs, there are multiple options available, from extra fine to fine, medium, broad, and 1.1 italic. The nib assembly can also be unscrewed from the section. So this is a JoWo nib unit section in whole. So you can remove it for cleaning purposes, or if you want to use another type of nib, then you can do that. And last, a size comparison between these two fountain pens. Here is a Lamy All-Star. Pretty much the same dimensions, and a Twisby Diamond 580, the ILR model. Let me give it like that. Okay, so good size fountain pen from this perspective. Okay. So let's proceed with the writing sample. As mentioned in my previous video, I'm using this one with an ink converter, as you can see. I think I'm using KWZ Azure number 5, if I remember correctly, in this one. And this one, for sure, in the eyedropper, I'm using the Noodler Sync Heart of Darkness. Again, very nice fountain pens, very nice material, the way they've transformed the brass material and how they've chosen to do it. It's very nice. We're gonna use multiple types of paper, four types as usual, and we're gonna try really quickly both fountain pens. So we will zoom in and we will start with the Bronze Age model. Again, both nibs are medium, so this is the fine writing. Bronze Age. We have a medium. Still, JoWo number 6 nib, which writes beautifully. It's excellent, and the ink is has a wet flow, at least with this particular ink, but not super wet. It's just right in terms of ink flow. The nib writes beautifully. It's an excellent experience, and I think that the people behind fine writing are also checking these JoWo nibs. So they are not quite the same nibs as they come from the factory. So they make sure that the nibs write properly, which is very nice. Also, I mentioned in my review video that We have a very good ink protection system inside the cap, and if you choose to use the thin metal box in which the fountain pen comes, then that will help as well with the ink starvation. So very low evaporation. This particular model is with the same ink for about 2 months. It stayed on my desk and also with me when I'm traveling, so no issues whatsoever, at least from my perspective. So this is the second model. We have the beautiful gold nib. This is the fine. Golden Armour. Again, a medium nib. If I remember correctly, maybe KVZ Azure 5. Again, an excellent experience, also a wet flow. Although this type of paper is very absorbent, so in terms of paper, because I didn't mention that, we have 120 GSM by Mondi. Okay, let's continue with the Tomoe River paper, 52 grams in ivory, and I'll be quicker. So this is the fine writing bronze. Each. Yeah, a wet flow. Wet ink flow. Okay, the third type of paper, we are using the Lamy paper, 90 grams. Let's see. Again, an excellent experience. This paper is more absorbent than the Tomoe River, but again the experience is quite nice. The Golden Armour, the gold nib, it's a little bit finer than the silver steel nib from the Bronze Age, but also there is a difference between the two inks. Here we have the Noodler ink of Heart of Darkness. This one, I think it's KVZ, I may be wrong, I forgot, sorry. But again, both are quite nice. And finally, the Clairefontaine paper. Again, an excellent experience. I like better this silver nib than the gold nib. I like both of them, but I prefer this one, to be honest. Wet flow again. and the Golden Armour. So this is the last type of paper. Again, for both of them, very nice experience. That's pretty much it. Thank you for your time. I hope this was useful, and we'll keep in touch for the next review. Goodbye.